Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.2, Problem 5. This is Section 3.2, it's problem number 5. It says, consider the population 27, 14, 12, 16, 23, 9, 7, 16, 6, and 10. First, find the range. So the range is the biggest data value minus the smallest. So if you look through all the data, the biggest data value we have is 27. Minus the smallest data value is 6. And if you do the subtraction, 27 minus 6 is 21. The next part is find the variance. So to find the variance, you have to go through a four-step process. Step one is find the mean, label it X bar. Now technically X bar is the symbol for the mean of a sample, which is usually what you're dealing with. Sample is part of the group you're studying. Population is the entire group you're interested in studying. This is a population, usually they're really huge. This is an unusually small example of a population, but it's good to mix that into the homework. So if you label it X bar, you still get the right answer, it's fine, but if you really want to do a nice job, the proper symbol for the mean of a population is mu. It's a letter from the Greek alphabet. So we'll add these numbers up. 27 plus 14 plus 12 plus 16 plus 23 plus 9 plus 7 plus 16 plus 6 plus 10. And we'll divide by 10 because there are 10 data values. So now we'll get a total for the top. That's kind of a lot of numbers. I could probably do without the calculator, but we'll do 27 plus 14 plus 12 plus 16 plus 23 plus 9 plus 7 plus 16 plus 6 plus 10 equals. And the top gives me a total of 140. So I have 140. And again, 10 in the denominator, so that I can do without the calculator. 140 divided by 10 is 14. So that's step one. The mean is 14, which we actually labeled mu this time. Again, the reason being we're dealing with a population this time and not a sample. So step two is fill out that chart. So the chart has three columns. The first column is X. The middle column is typically X minus X bar, but again, because it's a population, to really do a nice job, we'll label it X minus mu, because mu is the X bar for a population. And the last column will be X minus mu in parentheses raised to the second power. So, now the first column for X is just simply the data that's given to you in the question. So, just fill it in. We'll have 27, 14, 12, 16, 23, 9, 7, 16, 6, and 10. Those are the different values of X. Now, from each value of X, I'm going to subtract off the mean, which again we label mu this time. Usually it's X bar. So my value for mean is 14. So X minus the mean will be 27 minus 14. 27 minus 14 is 13. The next value of X is 14. So X minus the mean in this row is 14 minus 14, which is 0. And the next value of X is 12. So X minus the mean, 12 minus 14 is negative 2. And the next value of X is 16. So 16 minus the mean is 16 minus 14, which is positive 2. The next value of X is 23. So 23 minus the mean is 23 minus 14, which will be positive 9. And then the next value of x is 9. So x minus the mean is 9 minus 14, which would be negative 5. The next value of x is 7. So 7 minus the mean, 7 minus 14 is negative 7. The next value of x is 16, so 16 minus the mean, 16 minus 14 is positive 2. The next value of x is 6, 6 minus the mean, 6 minus 14 is negative 8. And finally, the last value of x is 10, so 10 minus the mean, 10 minus 14 is negative 4. Now, at this point, especially with a long list, it's nice to see that your middle column has a total of 0. So, and I'll use the calculator to help me out. The positive values, I have 13, positive 13, positive 2 is 15, 24, 26. So I have a positive 26. My negatives, negative 2, negative 7. Another negative 7 is negative 14, negative 22, negative 26. So it does work out. We have positive 26, negative 26. That means the middle column has a total of 0, which is a good sign. If it didn't, it would be sure that I made a mistake. So the last column, we'll take our result for x minus mu, or x minus the mean, and raise it to the second power. So in the top row, the previous column, we had an answer of 13 for x minus mu, so we'll do 13 second power. 13 times 13 is 169. The next row, the x minus the mean was 0, so we'll have 0 second power, 0 times 0 is 0. The next row down, x minus mu was negative 2, so negative 2 second power, negative 2 times negative 2, positive 4, again the negative times negative cancels. The next row down, the x minus the mean was 2, so 2 second power, 2 times 2 is another 4. And the next row down, x minus mu is 9, so 9 second power, 9 times 9 is 81. And then the next row, x minus the mean was negative 5, so negative 5 to the second power, negative 5 times negative 5 is positive 25. And the next row down, x minus the mean was negative 7, so negative 7 second power, negative 7 times negative 7 is positive 49. Then the next row down, x minus mu was 2, so 2 second power, 2 times 2 is 4. And the next row, x minus mu was negative 8, so we do negative 8 second power, negative 8 times negative 8 is positive 64. And finally in the bottom row, x minus mu is negative 4. Negative 4 second power, negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16. So that's step 2. Step 2 is fill out the chart, and there's the chart. We filled it out quite a few rows, but realistically speaking, this is still a fairly small problem. A lot of the standard deviation and variance problems are bigger than this, and you can solve them with software. So now, step 3, get a total of the last column. Again, I'll use the calculator to help me out with that. So I'll do 169. I don't really have to do plus 0. I can just go right to plus 4, plus 4 again, plus 81, then plus 25, plus 49, plus 4, plus 64, plus 16. So my total comes out to 416. That's the answer for step 3. The total of the last column is 416. Step 4, take the result from step 3, divide by n minus 1 if you have a sample, divide by n if you have a population. This is a population, so we'll divide by n, where n is how many data values in the question. So 416 divided by n is 416 divided by 10, because n is 10, n is how many data values. We have 10 data values, so n is 10. And this I can divide without a calculator. 416 divided by 10 is 41.6. Now, that's the variance. The variance is 41.6. Now, if you want to use the proper symbol for it, since it's a population, it's sigma to the second power. Sigma is the S from the Greek alphabet. So usually sample variance, it's S second power, but for population, it's sigma second power, the Greek S. And now standard deviation will be square root of whatever the variance was. So square root of 41.6, which I will use my calculator for, is 6.44980619. I'd like to round that off. So standard deviation equals, within some round off, 6.45. And again, to use the proper symbol, it would be the lowercase s from the Greek alphabet, which is sigma. The standard deviation of the population, sigma, equals a little less than 6.5, 6.45.